Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today I'm going to show you how to create a dark, moody effect in Mac Photos. So MacMost is brought to you by a community of more than 350 supporters. Find out how you could become a part of it at MacMost.com/Patreon. So it's really popular today to apply effects and filters to your photos to create a mood. To make it dark and moody, make it a little bluish, bring out some of the shadows. And you can do that typically in things like Lightroom or Photoshop, but I'm going to show you how to do it today just using photos. So let's use this photo as an example. It shows a forest during the day. There's sunlight coming through. It's very green and bright. And we're going to try to make it moodier. So we're going to click Edit to get into the editing tools. And from there, we're going to start by working with the light. So I'm going to click here to reveal all of the options for light. If you don't see these, you have to click options there to open that up. So there are many different ways to get this kind of effect. I'm going to show you one that I came up with, but you can also make other adjustments to come up with the same thing. There's a lot of repetition here. For instance, you've got curves and levels, and you could do the same kinds of things with them. So the first thing I want to do is drop the exposure down. Then I'm going to actually drop the highlights down as well. So the highlights are going to focus on the brightest parts of the photo. So the sunlight coming through now is muted. I'm going to bring out the shadows. So I'm going to go all the way up with the shadows. That's going to bring out the darkest parts of the photo. So now that I've got that done, I want to move on to color. And under color, I'm also going to open options if you don't already have that, and bring down the saturation. I don't want to bring it down all the way. That makes it to basically a grayscale or black and white photo. I'm going to bring it down maybe halfway, maybe three quarters of the way. I want there to still be a hint of green here. These are, after all, trees. I'm going to bring it down like that. Now I want to go and create that blue effect. So I'm going to use curves to do that. You can use levels, but I found it quick and easy to do it in curves. In curves, usually you'll start off in RGB here and you want to switch to blue. And what we want to do is change that line. So I'm going to grab the top right corner of that line and bring it over about one quarter of the way. Now, if you aren't careful, you could very easily accidentally click a little bit down that line and now you're making this curve, which is going to make it easy to blow out the blue color there. So you want to make sure you grab that top right corner and you're actually dragging a line there. So I'll bring it there. Different photos are going to need different amounts. Sometimes you have to bring it halfway. This one definitely halfway is too much. I'm going to bring it one quarter. Now that I've got that, I'm going to go back up to the light here and I'm going to change brightness. I'm going to make it darker until I get just the right look. And I find doing this last really helps because different photos need different things. So now there you go. That's kind of the effect I was after. I can use the tool here to show the photo with and without adjustment. So I can click and hold and see there's the original and I can see there's my moody version. Like I said, there's more than one way to do this. Another way I found to do it is to use one of the filters and then do a few adjustments after that. So let's go to another photo, look at another example here. I'm going to go to this churchyard with the graves in it. This is the perfect one where it's just too bright. Look how green that grass is. Look how bright that sky is. Let's give this some moodiness. So I'm going to go to Edit, but instead of jumping right to the Adjustment Tools, I want to go to Filters. And one of the filters that comes with photos is Dramatic Cool. Now what I would like it to be is Moody Cool, but I'll use Dramatic Cool as a starting point. So now I can go to Adjustments here, and I find that if I jump right away to Saturation and desaturate it to get rid of a lot of that green, but still leave a hint of it there, that works out really nice. Now it's not going to have enough of that blue effect here. So I'm also going to go and make the blue curve adjustment that I made before. Once I get it to there, then I'm ready to jump right to brightness and make it a little less bright. So now you can see the change there. And I'm accomplishing more or less the same thing, just using some different tools. So of course the exact adjustments are going to depend on the photo itself, the type of mood you're trying to create, and your personal style. But it gives you an idea of what you're going to do with those adjustment tools in Photos.